I don't know. Revival had one chance, and that song alone is greater than all of JRK. Hello again and welcome back to another one. And today we have a couple of topics to run through, from Eminem songs making the list of Hip Hop DX Best Hip Hop Songs of 2020, Crook talking about Eminem and Joe Budden's relationship, 50 Cent getting trolled in reaction to his latest troll attempt, and also a hilarious exchange that reveals why sometimes it's best to not bother on social media. As we dive in, if you enjoy content like this, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe if you're new, hit the notification bell, and find me on social media at italistar_web. So we'll get 50's latest trolling attempt out of the way first, and following what a few rappers have done to resuscitate their cash flow by joining site-only fans, 50 Cent decided to drop this. I'm getting back in shape. Girl, you wanna see? Go to my LOL OnlyFans page. Now why would you go looking at I'm a boy, Damon, WTF, I changed my mind, LOL. Now in the past few weeks, I covered news about someone who once owned a magazine that was struggling to cover the rent and later turned to OnlyFans after hitting the juice gene. So who knows, 50 was probably throwing a jab at that, and someone over on Reddit also picked up on this. Think he's trolling with Benzino. However, since the second part of the tweet was hard to follow, 50's troll attempt didn't go so well, as some have reacted stating, "Can someone translate this to English for me?" To which a user responds, "50 can't write good grammar most times, not sure why, lol." But more hilarious reactions were yet to come, and one user expanded, "That's why Floyd can't read, cause 50 can't write." And 50 was really getting some hands with some of the jokes, and another user added, "I see what 50 did here. He wrote this with a bullet in his mouth, just think about it." And moving on, Eminem songs make another publication's list of best songs of 2020. A few days ago, it was Cosmopolitan magazine, and now Hip Hop DX recently added The Adventures of Moonman and Slim Shady and Ya Ya to their list. And from the looks of it so far, it wasn't just this platform that shadowed Eminem's darkness, as these publications have all ignored that song. And many pointed this out in the comment section. One user states, "No love for darkness." Another one asked, "No Eminem darkness?" And over on Twitter, a user broke it down. "I don't like the way publications have been leaving darkness off their year-end list. Darkness is vintage Eminem, his pen is elite on this song, and conceptually, it's his best song since then, proving he's still capable of writing at a high level. But who are we kidding? US outlets and radio actually did ignore Stan initially when it dropped, hence why it only managed to peak at number 51 on the US Hot 100 at that time, while internationally it peaked at number 1 in like 14 countries, so maybe we have to give it more time." Moving on, in a recent interview with Crook on Premier Live TV, he spoke a bit about Joe Budden and Eminem sorting things out, and it's safe to say that he remains hopeful based on some of his comments, and I quote, "One day I'm hoping that him and Em would be able to sit down. They don't gotta be friends again, they don't gotta do none of that, just be men and sit down. Because guess what? The two, they cut from the same cloth, they're really deep artists, they love their craft. If you listen to M Stan and Joe's fan, it's a lot of similarities, and they're good dudes trying to do the right thing. And I just feel like all that was just for no reason, and I really wish they will sit down and it might happen." And over there in the comments section, a user adds this, "I really hope that Joe and M will have that conversation. Hip hop needs a final Slaughterhouse album." And we know how it all started. Joe lit the fuse with his mouth, something that Crook also touched on in the interview, but I'll throw this one over to you guys. Are you as hopeful as Crook? Moving on, there's an exchange on Twitter that made the rounds on Reddit, an exchange between fans in regards to Revival and Kanye's JRK album, after a user on Twitter stated, "JRK is worse than Revival, I don't care." To which another user responds, "JRK way more enjoyable." But here's why we are covering this today. Another user responds with, "I don't know, Revival had one chance, and that song alone is greater than all of JRK." To which the previous user responds, "Use this gospel and on God clear." That then gets this response, "Better than no chance?" And that user responds, "Yes, more enjoyable." And then the user spills the tea, "Bro, there's no song called No Chance by Eminem, I made it up." And this exchange blew up on Reddit a few hours ago, to which a user reacts stating, "Only Kanye stans can make themselves look worse than M stans." And one user gives too much credit, stating, "Wouldn't your first response be to just go on Spotify and listen to No Chance?" And clearly, even some fans doubted themselves when they saw this initially, one user states, "Bro, I was like, wait, there's a song called One Chance?" How did I miss it? So that will be all. Comment below and see you on the next one.